Hey guys, welcome to Hack Interactive English, the program to improve your English listening ability. And we are your hosts. My name is Oliver.
And I'm Henry. Okay, today's lesson is about altruism. Hey, do you know what altruism is?
Of course I know. Wait a second. As I know, it's a kind of willingness to bring advantage to other people, even if it results in negative effect for yourself.
Did you just directly excerpt it from the dictionary?
No, not at all, dude. You're hilarious for that.
Anyway, today we are honored to welcome our special guest to share their story with us. Let's welcome Dr. Wells and Rebecca.
Hello?
Dr. Wells?
Hi, I'm here. Hi, I'm Dr. Wells, 17 years old, from California.
Okay. It's good to see you.
Yeah, my pleasure.
Thank you for inviting me. The pleasure is mine.
Right, so we are here to show the audience your special experience. And without further ado, let us begin.
Okay, I remember it was 30 years ago. When I was a child, my dad was obsessed with helping people.
Mr. Chenning was not rich, but generous, and he made a living by running a shop in the stand.
Yes, he didn't earn lots of money by running the stand, but it was still enough for us to go on.
I see. So can you talk about how the story began?
Okay, my dad passed away when I was only 5. My family and I live in a small hood. My mom, she took 3 jobs so that she could raise me and my 2 little brothers. We had a tough time. And all the money we earned was totally paid for rent. The enormous pressure and toll eventually knocked her out. She couldn't get to work. Not to mention raising and taking care of us. And I had no choice but
he had no alternative but to steal money from the stand.
Yeah, that's the thing that I regret for my entire life.
I understand. You must be so desperate as to make the decision.
Yeah, and the sense of guilt eventually forced me to hold back. But, you know, it was too late.
Huh? Wait a second. What do you mean, too late?
Well, I caught him red-handed.
Yeah, and that was the moment that my life drastically changed.
How could that be possible? Yeah. Drastically changed?
Sounds crazy, right?
But it was true. And the fun thing is that, from some perspectives, I felt grateful that I stole the only knife. Because if I hadn't, I wouldn't have met Mr. Chenning. And perhaps now, I'm not a successful doctor, but an impoverished guy.
That's really touching. So, Rebecca, what did you do after you caught him?
Well, at the first time, I was trying to call the cop, but then my dad came over and stopped me and asked Wells why he didn't let.
So what did you say to him? Did you tell the truth or just run away?
Well, I did hesitate for a while. You know, that's not easy for a 10-year-old boy.
Indeed.
But I still told him the truth and begged him for his forgiveness.
Then I realized he was just a boy at the same age as me. Anyway, my dad helped me now, you know, as usual. And even paid the medical fees for his mom. I was mad at that time. Hey, Daddy, why would you rather help those people than buy me a stuffed animal?
I can totally understand why you are so furious.
All right, guys.
Hey, let me finish
that's
first.
That's enough.
Why must you be so personal?
Calm down, Harry. Now, please continue the story, Rebecca.
Okay. On the afternoon, just like other normal days, we were working at a stand, a beggar coming through, and my dad getting him some food just like what he did every single day. But when he was about to pass the ball to the beggar, he suddenly passed out on the ground.
Dad, what happened to you? Are you okay?
I was shocked and rushed him to the hospital right away.
Dad.
After a couple of hours rescue, his situation had become stable. But he was still in critical situation. And the worst thing is that he has been diagnosed with a brain tumor.
What? Brain tumor?
Brain tumor?
The brain tumor?
Brain tumor!
Be quiet. Let me finish later, okay?
Sorry.
Okay. Seeing the receipt of the medical fees, I knew we definitely didn't have the money to pay for that astonishingly expensive surgery, even if I sold out the stand and everything we possessed.
That must be painful to you.
Absolutely. But then, things started turning smooth, all because of Wells.
Oh, come on, don't say that. I'm just trying to pay your father back. What I did is nothing compared with what your father had done before.
So what on earth did you do to pay him back?
Actually, it's a coincidence. After I become successful in career, I tried to search for Mr. Channing, but I just couldn't until I saw his case study on my table.
Oh my God.
Then I decided to perform this surgery for him free of charge without any hesitation.
I was very shocked to know the doctor's true identity. What my father had done before was finally repaid.
Yeah, and I was thankful to God for granting me this opportunity because during the past 30 years, I was wondering how to find this man who shaped my life and expressed my gratitude to him.
That's really lucky for both of you. So, Rebecca, how's your father now?
He's fine.
Yeah, his condition is in control and getting well soon.
Wow, that's awesome. Just like the scenes of a movie.
Movie?
What?
Whoa.
But Whoa. It did happen in reality. Hopefully our audience like our special guest story and life experience.
Oh, it's about time. So do Dr. Wells and Rebecca have anything or suggestions wanted to say to our audience?
Well, I'm glad to be here to share my experience with you guys. I just want everyone to know that your help to someone in need may be a quite significant factor influences not only the person, but also you and everyone around you. So just help others as much as possible, no matter how insignificant it seems to be.
Undoubtedly, God is watching what we are doing. We have no idea when the seeds of good deed will blossom.
And conversely, if you owe someone a favor, you should keep that in mind, which can become your motivation. That makes you stronger and successful. Then one day, you have the chances to repay, or even do another favor to the public and the world.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, Hack Interactive English is about to end. Thanks for our special guest sharing, and hopefully you all have a nice day.
Yes, and if you have something that is quite similar to our topic, please contact us at our website,
www.hack.com.
Maybe you'll be the next one staying here sharing your life story with us.
Yes, and we are here waiting for you all. I'm your host, Henry.
And I'm Oliver.
See you next time.
Speaking of altruism, could you guys do us a favor?
Yes, of course.
Could you buy us a stuffed animal?
Please.
Huh? Oh, come on.